All right, I'm back now with Stephanie Blaze, and we also have John Orndorff. He's back there behind the mask. We'll talk to him in a minute. But they are going to tell us about the Fantastic Puppets and the rest of their season that you guys have for the theater department.
Yes,
thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, well, first of all, let's talk about this, because this is quite the spectacle. When I walked in today, it was like, whoa, what is this? So you guys worked with the Arkansas Arts Center on this.
Yes, we did. The Arkansas Arts Center Children's Theater handcrafted these puppets specifically for our show. We're very, very thankful. They were very wonderful. They kept us involved throughout the entire process, from first sketches to final product. And they were open to answer any questions that we had. They helped us with any fixes that needed to happen. They even came and watched our final production of it.
Wow.
They were very wonderful to collaborate with.
And during the production, this guy actually walks, and it takes how many people to move this thing?
This thing takes 5 people to operate, and they have to work as one. So it was really meticulous trying to get them to become one body. The steps had to be at a certain rhythm. The hands had to move together. They all had to move as one unit. Whenever you're behind in this thing, you can't see anything. So they really had to become an ensemble for this, and they did a beautiful job of it.
That is amazing. Now, we talked about how resourceful you guys are with everything and how they were able to pull all this together. Some of this is a Swiffer mop?
Yes, the feet have Swiffer mops in them, and that's how they're able to have flexibility and move like an actual foot.
Wow. That is so cool. And let's talk about the dog over here.
Yes.
Because I was reading that this took a lot of work to kind of get the movement of the dog down.
It did. She did a wonderful job, Kaylee McCoy. She operated the puppet, and she spent any of her offstage time learning how to make it natural, how to move like a dog, how to sound like a dog. She found cute little moments to wag the tail and to find some realistic movement with it. There's a spring in the middle of the body.
Can I pet him?
Okay, that allows it to move naturally.
Look at that. That is so cool. I love it. All right, now let's talk about, if John wants to come out from behind our big guy back here. What was this play again a part of?
This was Wiley and the Hairy Man.
Wiley and the Hairy Man. Okay, now John, what's next for you guys?
Next, we have 3 more things in our season coming up next week. It's Barefoot in the Park,
which is a student-directed production, student-directed, student-design, and we're doing that in collaboration with our art center that's local in town. So we have Barefoot in the Park.
We also have a student-directed play. He wrote it and directed it himself. It's
Five Minutes to Curtain
by Jared Hunt, April 2nd. 3rd and 4th, and we have Putnam's 25th Annual Spelling Bee, April 22nd to 26th.
Yeah, that's a musical, and it involves audience participation, which is super exciting.
I have heard about this one.
Yes, we are so excited.
Well, that will be a blast. And you guys invite the community out to come and see these productions?
Oh, yeah, we're really involved with our community. We love having people come out and support. We love doing preview nights for them, $1 preview nights, so
yeah. What's it like for you guys to get that on-stage experience? Because there are a lot of acting students that don't necessarily get to be immersed in big productions like this.
Yeah. Well, John, you were the lead of Wiley and the Hairy Man. What was that like on your end? I haven't acted in so long.
It's really fun. It's a great opportunity. Build up your resume, get you experience before you get out into the real world. It was fantastic getting to work with all of our crew and the student designers, which is something we do in the spring, whereas in the fall it's normally designed by faculty who have been doing it for years.
We have a really small department, so we're really close-knit. We get that family experience. We have an abundance of opportunities because we're small.
And this time we actually had a guest artist, Miss Tisha Duncans. She's from New York, and she's a professional actress, and she works with puppetry a lot. She was actually Rafiki in the European touring Lion King.
Awesome. Yeah, she came and taught us how to operate these puppets.
Wow.
It was a really, really awesome and wonderful experience. She was so pleasant to work with.
Yeah, well, I know if a freshman's interested in getting into theater, you guys welcome them with open arms, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. Like I said, we're small, but we're growing. We have that family atmosphere, and we would love to have as many people as possible come and join us and get to work with some cool stuff like this.
What an awesome time. All right,
yes,
well, thank you guys both for
thank
being
you.
Here. And thank you, everyone, for being here.